Cinderella of the staff room, eh?
Oh, Meg. Hi. Have you seen Rick?
Well, not since before lunch.
It's 20 past. I wanted to go myself. I'll check reception.
Hope he's all right.
Any reason why he shouldn't be?
Oh, if you'd seen his car, you wouldn't ask. It's an accident looking for a place to happen.
I'm sorry, Meg. I didn't mean to stare, but I was just thinking. You really do worry about everyone, don't you? Even the inmates.
No more than anyone else.
Rubbish. Will you do me a favour?
If I can.
Have dinner with me tonight.
Oh, well,
I've got two very special reasons. One, I need to talk to someone who really knows the inmates.
And?
And I'd like to take you to dinner.
Well,
please say yes. I've got a terrible persecution complex.
Thank you. I'd love to.
Great. I'll just get the rest of my stuff. Oh, I've heard the governor doesn't like fraternization, so it's between us two, okay?
I won't lag, I promise.
Oh, well, this is better. Back to normal, are we?
No way, we're doing our own gear and that's all.
Yeah, this place stinks enough without ponging up anymore.
That's enough, Hunt. You can go just as slow and solitary, you know.
Oh, Mrs. Powell, have you heard how Myra is?
She's regained consciousness, that's all I know.
Oh, terrific. One of our mates is dying and they won't tell us a thing about it.
Sorry, Keane. Didn't realise you and Desmond were so close.
Of course we are. Me and the top dog. Like that. She's my,
litter mate.
Colleague. So if the governor wants to talk this strike over, tell him the one to see, will you?
Good one, Rev.
Yes, Struth. I thought she was really going to blow his stack then.
So how did you go, Pick? What'd the cops say?
Well, that's just it, Cass. They didn't say anything.
You did tell them about Ralph?
Yes, and they were very nice about it. I mean, they wrote everything down, but, well, they didn't charge me.
You confessed and they didn't charge you?
No. Well, I'm sure they believe me, but, Cass, I'm awfully confused.
I hope Birmingham hangs on long enough to tell us something.
I doubt it. Sorry about that.
Don't be. You've done an incredible job, Rick. I'm sorry you went around to back you up.
It's not your fault. They had it well worked out.
Yeah, they were pretty good. Trouble is, it's bastards like these that give us a bad name. Ever thought of coming back in the force, Rick? You know, you would have got a promotion if you'd been in uniform.
No, I think I'll stop where I am. I got what I want now. Make a fresh start. And according to Maynard, it was them that planted the bomb.
And you killed them?
Yeah, well, I killed Mears, yeah.
It's a strange thing to ask. Do you feel any better for it?
I thought I would. When it was all over, I just... So what? Didn't bring Celia back, did it?
Everybody keeps telling me that I'll forget in time. I won't. I have to learn to live with it, but I won't forget it. Any more than you could forget Celia. As you say, all the hate's gone. So what?
Ah, there you are. Thought you might have gone home.
Not yet. Another half hour might see me out. Well, how did today go?
Very good, and I've got a full evening's reading ahead of me, background stuff on the inmates, that sort of thing.
Why don't you come home for dinner? I might be able to tell you what's written between the lines.
Now there's a tempting offer.
Curry chicken and a nice white burgundy?
You fight dirty, Reynolds. All right, what time?
Oh,
no, I can't really. I'll be up half the night as it is. And I can imagine how much work I'd get done with food like that and a beautiful wench in the kitchen.
All right, then another time.
Yes, please. Night.
See you tomorrow.
I suppose we'd have had poppadoms as well, eh?
Garlic and sesame seeds.
Oh, damn.
I'm sorry I'm late. Well, have they arrived yet?
Oh, yes, they're inside checking it over. And you've got absolutely nothing to worry about. They love it.
Well, how do you know that?
Well, because according to them, the kitchen's in the wrong place, the roof needs mending, and the entire house needs reblocking.
But that isn't true.
Well, of course it's not. If it was, they still wouldn't be inside. In a minute, he's going to come out and beat me down to $70,000.
Which is what we wanted in the first place, right?
Yeah, here they come out. Let me talk to him first. Mr. and Mrs. Webb, well, what do you think?
Well, I'll be truthful with you, Ross. Okay, the building's not bad, but there's a hell of a lot of work to be done.
And honestly, that back bedroom is a disgrace. I mean, how people can let their children go mad like that beats me. They must have been delinquents.
And have you seen the handyman efforts in there? Let's face it, Ross, the bloke must have been some sort of clown. 70,000.
Well, listen, why don't you and I just pop
just
inside?
Just a minute. It's Mr. and Mrs. Webb. Is that right?
Yes, that's right. And you're
a builder, are you, Mr. Webb?
No way. I wish I was, though, with this heap of junk.
Oh, well, look, I wouldn't worry about it if I were you, because you're obviously far too good for a place like this. Why don't you just leave?
Oh, I see. Sorry, dear. We were here first.
No, dear. I was. You see, that clown was my husband, and the delinquent was my son, so please leave.
Well, just a minute.
Get off this property, Mr. Webb, and take her with you now.
Am I getting better?
You sure are. Picture used the sharp end of the stick that time. Have another go, see if you can get one in the pocket, eh?
Yes.
Oh, hey, Jude.
Hi.
Oh, Bobby. How you feeling?
Oh, all right. Thanks, Cass. Jude told me what happened.
Okay, listen, I'm getting out of here.
Don't be stupid, they won't do anything.
Oh, it's all right. You weren't there.
Neither were you, Cordon or Alice. Now sit down.
Why could a block of chocolate do that?
Because it wasn't an ordinary block of chocolate. It had been loaded with laxatives. Who gave it to you?
Phyllis.
Yeah.
Oh, geez, I'm an idiot. I thought it was a bit strange at the time. Well, I've had it.
Oh, don't waste your time. It would have been Reb's idea anyway. Phyllis isn't bright enough to think of something like that. What do you think?
Well, I know Reb's no little angel, Jude, but she's been doing a good job keeping the strike going while Myra's been away. A real good job. I thought she might have changed to something.
No way.
But what'd she do it for?
Oh, use your life. She's jumped into Margot's boots.
She wants to be top dog. What else? There's no way she'd give it back to Myra when Myra returns. We don't want that now, do we?
Of course, the obvious choice is Pixie, but I haven't got the heart to do anything about her.
Why?
Well, correct me if I'm wrong, but I'd say that lady's got herself very well adjusted. She's just a happy little pixie, isn't she?
You're right. She really is quite amazing.
So who am I to change that?
But you will help Cass.
That's the third time you've asked me that. Why?
Oh, I don't know. I know she's killed twice, but...
Twice? I've got her down on record for three.
Well, the last time was self-defense. Anyway, I don't want to talk about it. It gives me nightmares. Look, why don't you sit down and make yourself comfortable and I'll get you something to drink, eh? Tea or coffee?
I'd prefer a scotch, if you wouldn't mind.
Right. I think I'll join you. Might help me to sleep. God, I miss those sleeping pills.
You don't need them, you know. Nobody does. I could help you if you'd let me.
Seriously?
Very. A full night's sleep every night. What do you say?
Well, yes, please.
Thank you.
How do I go about it?
Oh, it's easy. You just sit down. Here. Here'll do. Now, have you got a favourite piece of music? You know, something that relaxes you.
Oh, yes, that tape I had on when you arrived this evening.
Right. Oh, yes, perfect. Are you relaxed?
No.
Come on, just drop the shoulders now, just relax. Now, lie back, that's it. Now, just relax completely and listen to the music. Just relax, close your eyes. That's it, now just relax.
Thank you. I think I'll join you this time. Don't want to lose my license.
Thanks. I've been a damn nuisance.